How would you like to take incredible close-up images and videos with any camera? By the time this video is done, I'll explain what the magnification ratio of lenses is and how it affects your shooting, so stay tuned to the end. Photography, like any other art, demands both compelling content and expert technique to create a pleasing result. Nature, landscape, and wildlife are some of the most technically challenging fields in photography, and macro photography comes with its own unique set of technical considerations. In this video, I'll be discussing one of the most important challenges you'll face when shooting in macro: magnification. If you do any kind of specialty photography or videography, you'll get to a point where you need to start using specialized lenses. One of the most specialized lenses you'll come across is a macro lens. Hi, I'm Jim Costa. I'm a videography, photography, and technology guru, but you can call me a dadographer. I've created many other videos on videography, filmmaking, and more, and I'll link to those in the description below and both during and at the end of this video, so stay tuned. If you want to learn more, remember to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell to be notified when I upload new videos. I upload every week, and I'll be uploading many more explanations of film, video, photo editing, and technology topics. Stay tuned to the end to find out how to get my free DSLR and mirrorless camera cheat sheet that'll have you shooting like a pro in no time. Some of the greatest challenges in macro photography arise from the simple fact that we shoot from very close distances. Thus, the magnification of our subject becomes of primary importance. The magnification ability of a given lens is stated in its specifications, but in my experience, few photographers or videographers understand the meaning and implications of this designation. To understand the concept of magnification, it's worth taking a brief look at how a photo or video image is created. Every point in a given scene reflects light rays. The front element of the camera captures these light rays and then focuses them onto the imaging sensor, producing a projection of the scene at the location of the sensor. Magnification, or more precisely the magnification ratio, is simply the relationship between the size of the correctly focused subject's projection on the imaging sensor and the subject's size in reality. The magnification of any lens is determined by its focal length. For macro photography, we are also concerned with how close we can get to our subject. These two factors, focal length and minimum focusing distance, determine the lens's maximum magnification ratio, sometimes referred to as the reproduction ratio. The closer you can get to your subject with a lens of a given focal length, the higher the magnification ratio you'll achieve. The classic definition of a macro lens is one that has a maximum magnification ratio of at least 1:1 or 1x in lens specifications. This means that a subject can be reproduced at full size on the camera's image sensor. A 1/2 inch object can be projected onto the sensor as a 1/2 inch image when the lens is sufficiently close to the subject. A maximum magnification ratio of 1:2 or 0.5x would mean that the maximum size of an image could be projected onto the sensor just half its true size. A 2:1 ratio means that the subject capture will be twice its size. The numerical sequencing, moving from life size to smaller and smaller increments, is therefore expressed as 1:1, 1:2, 1:3, 1:4, and so on. Inversely, a magnification ratio of 2:1 or 3:1 means that the subject on film or the sensor will appear twice or three times its original size. So what is the significance of this? In close-up photography, the magnification ratio determines the level of detail revealed in the shot. As one moves closer to the subject, the total area recorded decreases, therefore magnifying the level of detail in the scene. Both 35mm and 50mm lenses can capture a subject at a 1:2 magnification. true macro lenses have a magnification ratio of 1:1, and true macro lenses tend to be quite costly. Now, if this is making sense to you, but I got it in the comments section below. My question of the day is, what would you shoot close up if you had a macro lens? Leave a comment below and let us know. With this brief video, you understand what a magnification ratio is and how it affects your images. So be sure to check what the magnification ratio is when you're buying a new lens, especially if you want to be a professional photographer or videographer, because it does make a difference in the images that you produce. Would you like to learn more about your camera settings to get you shooting like a pro? I've created an absolutely free cheat sheet for you on all the best camera settings for your DSLR, mirrorless, and video camera that will show you the settings that will allow your photos and videos to compete with the pros, regardless of what lens you use. The link to get that cheat sheet is just below in the video description. I've also created cheat sheets on other topics such as editing, and even now offer training courses on editing video using Adobe Premiere Pro, and soon I'll be doing other programs as well. I'll link to those cheat sheets and training courses in the description below as well. Do you want to see more videos like this? Follow my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, for many, many more. Think what you saw was great? Like it. Do you have an opinion? Comment below. Do you know someone who could benefit from the information that I provided? Then share a video. Do you want to learn even more? If so, then connect with Jim Costa Films on social media and online, on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, and the web. I currently have over 4,280 videos on my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, so feel free to check out many of my other videos for great video, film, editing, and technology tips, tricks, and suggestions. Now, if you follow me for a while, you know that I have a community of photographers, videographers, and filmmakers, just like you, on Facebook, where I share pro tips and tricks. It's called Video Producers and Content Creators. I love new members who want to share their work and learn from others. You'll find the link to the group in the description below. Feel free to join, where you'll learn even more.